Other lovers want to shout it out. Other lovers want to find it out. Other lovers want to cry it out. Others want to see it out. But us, you and me, my love, we never even tried it out. That's very interesting, because it's something that I've been seeing as a pattern in my life and in my relationships with men in general. Just having always that, being in a situation where it's not possible to be with them, you know, and yet wanting that and compromising myself and my emotional safety, you know, because of that idea of what it could be, you know, like when you share something with someone in a moment, it can be very intense and you feel like it's truth and you feel like this is it, you know, but then the circumstances don't allow for that relationship to happen or become something concrete, because then it just stays that sort of thing that is there, but no one is saying what it is, and it's a lot of confusion, you know. Some of the most powerful relationship and most memorable are like tend to be that, you know, tend to be that unfulfilled, you know. It's like there's always that hope, there's always that excitement. I think that's how it stays alive in you. And because of that, because you don't know what could have been, it always stays alive in you, and that person, you know, remains your lover on a certain level in yourself. And then also, just you can be with someone as like having a sort of lover relationship without actually being with them, you know. But if it's too strong, you know, if that desire to be together is too strong, but then you're not together, and it's not possible or something like that, I think it can be more destructive than beneficial.